Hey everybody, it's Keenan from Retool, back with another AI app build, and today we're tackling one of the most common but sometimes unintuitive file formats on the entire internet, the PDF. If you've ever had to extract a bunch of data from a dense PDF, especially one that doesn't support copy and paste, then you know exactly what I'm talking about. But luckily, we can build us a Retool app that will help us do just that. By the end of this video, we'll have an app that can take any PDF we can throw at it, extract the text from it, generate a summary for us, and also include a chat component that will allow us to ask any additional questions we might have about our document. Let's dive in. Okay, so now we're over here in Retool's app builder, and we're just gonna go ahead and add some of the components that we'll need to build this app. So we're gonna need a few different text components on here. This first one is gonna just be our heading, so we'll just say chat with PDF. This next one will just be instructions to our user, so we'll just say upload your file below and get an AI generated summary. Then use the chat component to ask any additional questions. Right, so this is just a little bit of intro for folks to let them know that they're in the right spot. We're gonna have here our heading, which will be where our document summary goes. And since we don't have our summary generated yet, we'll just say summary goes here. We'll leave this as a placeholder for now so that we know that that's where our summary is gonna go. This is a little bit of setup, but we actually need the file drop zone component next because that's where we will drop our PDF and we'll kick off all of our interesting data processing that's gonna happen. So we have this file drop zone. We need it to actually do something now, which we can do using Retool's event handlers. This is how we're going to trigger the query that will take action in our app. But first, we actually need to create that query. So let's do that. We're gonna use an AI action here, and we're gonna call this parse PDF, right? That's what we're gonna be doing. Retool AI is already pre-selected, and when Retool AI is selected as your resource, you get this drop-down list of actions. So we're going to pick, in this case, convert document to text. We're gonna tell it that we want it to look at the document in our drop zone that we've set up, and we're gonna hit save. The last thing we need to do to get this actually to work is on our drop zone, now that we have a query set up, we can use our event handler and say that when the file is parsed in the drop zone, we want to trigger our parse PDF query. And lastly, we'll just want to see what our actual output is here. So we'll use Retool's double curly brace syntax, which will let us access our query, and it will, you know, just output whatever our parse text is in this text field, which is what we need just for debugging for now. So I actually have a real estate listing here that's a pretty dense PDF, especially this description. And I want to be able to pull a bunch of information out of this. And so our app is going to let us do that. So we can see if we upload our PDF into our drop zone, our parse PDF query starts to run. And it actually does parse all of the text out of our PDF, which is great. But this, you know, it is text now that's readable, but it's not very useful yet. And especially since this is supposed to be a document summary, we need to do some adjustments here. So we're going to go create another query, another AI action. And you can see that one of our other actions we have here is summarize text. So we're gonna pick that. We're gonna call our query summarize PDF. And then this is where you would write your prompt or anything that you needed to have as input information for this AI query. So we're going to say, please summarize the following real estate listing, focusing on information that would be relevant to a buyer. And again, we can use Retool's double curly brace syntax to get the data from our parse PDF query in here. And you can see that it pre-fills so that we know that that data is in there, which is great. So we have that query saved, but now what we really need to do is make it so that when we upload a PDF, it parses. And then when the parse query runs successfully, it triggers our summarized query. So queries can have event handlers too. We will add a success handler here that says we want to trigger our summarized PDF query, and then we're gonna hit save. So now when the parse PDF query runs, which we'll do in a second, it should trigger our summarize query. The last thing we wanna do here is we want to update this text box so that it has the information from our summarize query because we want this to be a document summary. So we can test this whole chain of events out by running our parse query. And we should be able to see that that runs and our summarize query is also running. And now we have a proper summary here, which is pretty cool. So the next thing we want to do is actually add our chat component so that we can ask any questions that we might have about this listing that weren't present in our summary here. So when we drag a chat component onto the canvas, we can see our query is automatically created. all of this information is automatically set up for us in the way that we want to. If we wanted to choose a different model, you can do that here. We support OpenAI, Anthropic, as well as Bedrock and others if you have those configured. And we want to give this a bit of a system prompt. So we want to say, you are a helpful real estate assistant who can answer a prospective buyer's questions based on the listing information below, right? And then what we're going to do is actually use our parse PDF query here to include all of the listing information, right? So now if we save this query, the chat should have our context from our listing information. So let's give ourselves a little bit more space here and make our chat component just a little bit bigger. And so you see here, we still have the document summary, but now I can ask questions like, how many rooms are there in this apartment, right? And our chat component will run and it will say, great, the penthouse has a total of 23 rooms. What is the total square footage? And it will find that for us as well. And you can see that matches what we already see in the summary. But because this is a chat component, you can also ask it to do any of the sort of language tasks you might ask a large language model to do. So if you were a listing agent for this property, you could say, please generate an open house announcement for the listing provided. Right? And what this will actually do now is it will go ahead and start generating this for you. It has all the information about the listing. And so it will actually just generate, you know, the open house announcement, which obviously you wouldn't just send this out as is, but it can be a really great start. So this is one of the ways that you can, you know, use a PDF and use Retool AI queries to look at the data that's in the PDF a bunch of different ways. And that's it. Now we have an app that can take any PDF we might have, extract the text from it, give us a quick summary, and also let us ask any additional questions we might have about the document. If you want to try this app out for yourself, I will leave a link to it down in the description below. As always, if you have another idea for an AI app that you want to see me build, leave us a comment and let us know. Thanks for watching, and I'll see y'all next time.